Hello, 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 and welcome to Learn English Live 6. My name is Steve Ford, and I am happy to have a more engaging way to go over my questions, your questions, that I receive from my online students around the world. Yes, now I can record your question at the following link below. Cool! So we'll start off with a recorded message I received on my website, and I will address three of the questions I've received one by one. My first question comes from Javier from Spain, and here is Javier's question.
What cases do you make a subject verb inversion? Javier from Malaga, Spain.
Thanks for your question, Javier. I did cover this question in detail in my TOEFL video 13 about superstitions, so you can check that out. Let's take a look at how we can invert the subject and verb. Well, you want to start thinking about negative adverbials like seldom, rarely, barely, never. Now, a good rule of thumb for word order of adverbs of frequency is to put them between the subject and the verb.
Common order for frequency adverbs. Subject, adverb, verb. I seldom cry. I barely eat. I never dance. Boo-hoo.
You can put them in a sandwich together like that.
What did Steve just say? Watch the slow motion replay.
You can put them in a sandwich together like that.
How do native speakers link these words together? Put them. Put them. In a. In a. Put them in a. Say it four times slowly. Are you ready? Put them in a, put them in a, put them in a, put them in a. Now faster. Put them in a, put them in a, put them in a, put them in a. Now really fast. Put them in a, 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 put them in a. You put them in a sandwich together like that. You can put them in a sandwich together like that.
In the case of inverting the word order, let's take the following sentence. I seldom walk under ladders. Not because it's bad luck, of course, but because I don't want the person at the top of the ladder dropping some bucket of water on my head. So step one, take out the adverb seldom. So I walk under ladders. Step two, make it into a question. Do I walk under ladders? And step three, add seldom to the beginning and drop the question mark. Seldom do I walk under ladders. This kind of sentence is only used in more formal speech. Say when a politician, doctor, lawyer, professor is speaking. This kind of grammar pops up all the time on academic tests, and you might hear it when you're watching movies and go, whoa, what was that? Another tricky inversion with the subject and verb is with neither or neither and nor. For example, she neither phoned me nor wrote to me, or nor wrote me. She neither phoned me nor did she write to me. The second part, nor, is part of a correlative conjunction, neither nor, or neither nor, as they call them, in the grammatical world, the grammatical universe. So I hope that clears up some of your doubts about inversion, Javier, and hasta luego. Next question is from a mystery student. Yes, she is invisible to us. Where is she? Yes, but we do have her recording. So I don't know where she's from. Maybe she's from South America, maybe she's from the Middle East, I really don't know. But maybe you, my viewers, can help me to find out where she's from by just listening to her voice.
What is the difference between although and however in a sentence?
Okay, well, back to our question. With some examples, Although I remember people's faces, I tend to forget their names. Does that ever happen to you? You remember someone only by the way they look, their face, not by their name, the way they're called. It's that woman, what's her face? So you are contrasting two facts here, and the one that starts with although is the one fact conceding to the following fact. That's important. Although could also be used in the middle of the sentence. I tend to forget people's names, comma, although I remember their faces. Through the years, a lot of students have asked me about the difference between though and although, or although. They mean the same thing, though, I'm not stuttering here, is considered less formal. If you really want to stress your point, you could also use even though interchangeably with although.
However.
Now, you could contrast two facts using however, but it would look as follows. I remember people's faces, period, full stop. However, I tend to forget their names. Putting however in the middle of the sentence is also possible by saying, I remember people's faces, comma, however, comma, I tend to forget their names. Notice how I offset however in the middle of the sentence by using commas. Remember, download this to your brain. Are you ready? Longer transitions like however, nevertheless, nonetheless, notwithstanding, need to be offset by two commas in the middle of a sentence. Now, for you really advanced students, it is important to know that however and those other longer transitions can join two clearly independent clauses. But you need to offset however, or the others, with a semicolon followed by a comma. If you can use that sometimes in your higher level writing, you will have become a black belt. A master of English grammar, yes.
Black belt of English grammar. Nobody can stop you now. It is a foregone conclusion that life is an illusion. However, the majority of people still think life is real.
My next question is as follows.
Hi, Steve. I am Rafael from Brazil, and I got a question for you. I realized the verb to get have a lot of different meanings, and to add food to the fire, it can be used as base verb to some phrasal verbs. So could you explain some meanings of that verb?
This is a great question from Rafael from Brazil. Get is so complicated that I made my video Steve in Paris, three of them in fact, using a long list of get phrasal verbs. That was back in 2008, and I can see that I still need to make some more videos about that. So here is a good review from the beginning of Steve in Paris.
Get, arrive, I get home at 5, get on, enter, I got on the tube train, get around, go from place to place, get around town by subway, get good at, to become good at, I got good at using maps, get off, to leave a train or a plane, I got off at the wrong stop.
Have you ever taken the subway or bus and got off at the wrong stop? You get off the bus, and before you can get back on, it's too late. Where am I? It's that sudden moment when we get confused and mixed up, and I don't like it. Yeah. Your wife, girlfriend, or whoever that might be says to you, we're lost. Why don't we get a GPS device? Or better yet, let's ask that person on the corner there. And you're like, no, I am king of finding things. I am super locator. Yes, I always know where I am. Well, maybe not. You get the picture. Well, everybody, I want to thank everyone who sent me a recording of their question to me for a more interactive learning experience. Learn English Live 6. More videos are on their way. Mrs. Ford and I are going to be filming tomorrow, and I hope you have a great day. Bye-bye.
Put them in a sandwich together like that. You can put them in a sandwich together like that.